Researchers believe there is a shift in what is considered the traditional tornado alley. This shift now includes portions of western Ohio. All this week, Chief Meteorologist Eric Elwell takes us behind the weather, and tonight we explore Tornado Alley.
Kansas and Oklahoma. Those probably come to mind when you hear of Tornado Alley. But a study in the journal Climate and Atmospheric Science suggests a shift eastward that includes now parts of western Ohio.
Now, the National Weather Service does now say this is a tornado emergency.
Okay.
For Montgomery County. Tornado emergency. Confirm okay. Large and extremely dangerous tornado located near Trotwood, folks.
The events of this past Memorial Day certainly add evidence to the results. 21 tornadoes touched down in Ohio that night. Of those, 15 happened in the western third of the state. The National Weather Service in Wilmington was busy that night and the days that followed. Their teams of investigators would visit 10 Ohio counties and confirm 19 of the state's 21 tornadoes. Science and Operations Officer Seth Bienow says the reason for the Memorial Day outbreak is pretty simple.
Warm front. Around here we say warm fronts in May, you really have to be careful with.
As meteorologists, we have satellite images, we have Doppler radar, and we have computer-generated models and observation systems. While we knew it could potentially be a difficult night, we didn't anticipate to what extent.
I don't think we saw to that level. These storms were very proficient at tornado genesis because of the presence of the warm front and how instability and wind shear tended to overlap in this favored corridor. These supercells congealed but remained separate in terms of their processes. We didn't get cold outflow outrushing. The balance of shear and instability in the atmosphere was perfect, and so they retained some of their supercell characteristics. I think a much longer into the state of Ohio and much deeper into the night than we had anticipated.
The twisters produced in western Ohio on May 27th included some of the most powerful and destructive tornadoes Ohio has ever seen. An EF3 tornado began in the eastern edge of Montgomery County and tore a path through the city of Beaver Creek. It ripped the roof off an Aldi store and left debris wrapped around trees. Just to the west of where that tornado began, an even bigger monster had ended. An EF4 tornado carved a path more than a half of a mile wide for 20 miles. It ripped homes and businesses apart in the city of Trotwood before tearing through Dayton. Winds were estimated with that tornado at 170 miles per hour. And farther to the north in Mercer County, an EF3 tornado came through Salina. Winds with that tornado as high as 150 miles per hour. It leveled houses, knocked a trailer on its side, tore roofs off a building, and completely flipped a car. It also claimed a life when a parked car was blown into a house and killed an 82-year-old man. The storm came in so fast, people did not have much time to take cover.
Well, I was sitting on the front porch watching the rain. It was real quiet and wasn't windy or nothing. I seen a big flash of lightning. I decided it was time to go in. I went in, went in my bedroom right up against the wall, and just the time I got to the bedroom, it was here and gone.
Studying tornadoes like this one may help save lives. Research like that, conducted by Victor Cincini at North Illinois University, helps identify trends. But the question remains, why are we seeing a shift in Tornado Alley?
So we've seen our tornado numbers come up, maybe from an increase in frequency, and there's some scientific research out there that substantiates that the environments that support tornadoes have been on the increase in the Ohio Valley. But we also have to talk about our detection and our knowledge of those events.
Research shows a shift to the east in the traditionally accepted Tornado Alley. The evidence points to climate change, but what we don't know yet is if that change is natural or human-induced.
There's never been any very high-resolution research done on the frequency and spatial distribution of tornadoes in western Ohio.
There's also the possibility the topography of western Ohio comes into play. But again, the jury is still out.
400 feet of terrain change. Is that enough to alter low-level wind flows such that a thunderstorm coming along feels a different low-level wind shear profile than it did back in eastern Indiana. It's hard to say. We haven't done research to that degree.
Knowing that western Ohio has become more of an active recipient of tornadoes gives us a better perspective when we're forecasting and help us save lives. The destruction left behind after Memorial Day reminds us of how much worse things could have been.
I sit here today in awe how we didn't lose more life. When I'm out on the survey in Brookville, one neighborhood becomes two neighborhoods becomes four neighborhoods. Windows all blown out, projectile missiles into the living rooms, the roof is gone, exterior walls pulled out. You're looking right into people's bedrooms. And that's just not one or two instances. That's repeated hundreds of times along this tornado track. And it boggles my mind how we didn't have more fatalities. And I think there's a very real discussion that needs to be had on what the reasons were behind that. I would love to know personally, because I've seen these types of tornadoes affect far fewer homes with higher fatality rates. So something is very unique about this.
For Spectrum News One, I'm Chief Meteorologist Eric Elwell.
Tomorrow evening on Spectrum News One, we're going to go inside tropical systems and learn about their past effects.